Hello friends, I hope you are doing fine. Today I am here with yet another video about gardening. You cannot see any plant in front of me. You cannot see any seeds in front of me. So what I am up to? This is a plastic bottle and I am going to show you how we can create a complete hydroponic system in a very cheap way from an old plastic bottle. Now we all have so many of waste material in our house which we throw away without thinking that they can be reused, and some of these are really hampering our environment. So we should be very careful when we are choosing such kind of materials which can be recycled, and instead of recycling we are just throwing them away. One such material is the plastic bottles. We get so many plastic bottles, cold drink bottles, milk bottles, and so many other things, where juices, where we get these plastic bottles from. So take a plastic bottle. This must be a 5 liter plastic bottle. And what else do we need? So this plastic bottle, I have not put it in a vertical way, but I have put in a horizontal way so that you can make sure, you can just guess that this is going to be our horizontal hydroponic system. Many of you must have seen the hydroponic system. How does it look like? Okay, I'll pause here and I'll show you a picture. How does it looks like? So by now you saw this picture and you know how the hydroponic system looks like. So we have a base where we fill it with water, then we have small openings here on the top where we insert the hydroponic cups or the pots, you can say. But these pots, if you purchase it online, these are really expensive. I mean, just for creating a hydroponic system, why would you like to spend so much? If that can be done at home. Yeah, that can be done at home. So I have got three small pots with me, rather glasses, which will convert into pots, and I'm going to show you how this is going to work. So if you see, this bottle can be divided into three parts, 1, 2, and 3, and 1, 2, and 3, and I have not done any kind of symmetry or mathematics here. This is how the bottle is made. So we are going to utilize the same infrastructure of the bottle and convert it into our hydroponic system. So if you see, this one portion has a slight bulging at the end. This is not as straight as these two portions. This is slightly bulged. So what we are going to use, we are going to make use of a slightly bigger glass, which will go inside like this, diagonally or in a tilted manner, you can say, and the rest of the two glasses. So one I have with me, see this, it is going to go straight, and the other we are going to cut from this bottle. So this will also go in straight. And in the image which I just showed you, you must have seen the hydroponic pots, which are very very commonly used. So similar kind of pots we are going to drive from these three small glasses. So stay tuned and I'll show you how this is done. Now what I have done is, I have taken this marker, permanent marker, black in color, you can take anything, just to make mark on this bottle. So if you see, you have a circle here, then a circle here, and then a circle here. So three circles for three glasses or three cups or three hydroponic pots. And if you see, these two are really close to each other. So while cutting, you make sure that you shift this line slightly this side, so that this line can be cropped in here. And so we have this complete bulging which is in the center. This is partition between the two pots. This remains as a partition between the two pots. And the pots and the lines which we have created, make sure when you are cutting these, that you don't go outside the edge of these lines. It should be inside, because you cannot let your glass just loosen up and they just fall inside this pot. You should make them stick to the boundaries. You should make them that they just remain intact with the boundaries. And a similar kind of hydroponic marks we have made on these bottles. So if you see, we have made, let me just, okay. So we have some marks at the base, and then we have three lines, three vertical lines, almost covering half of this pot. So I've covered half of this pot with the understanding that this half will submerge inside the bottle and the remaining above, remaining pot will remain on the top. So once I submerge it and I feel that the pot length should be reduced, then we can definitely cut it from this starting. So here we are ready to cut it with the marks we just made. So take a sharp knife and make the cuts. So now if you see, all our three small pots are placed inside this bigger bottle, and if you see the markings, half or one third, whatever we marked on each of them is completely submerged into water, and there are holes which we made in all of these small pots. So we have placed it here. Next step is to put soil, or I would prefer better compost mixed with the cocoa peat, because this is lighter and it is very good for your seeds to germinate, since we are going to start the process with the germination of seeds. Before that, we have to fill water in this bottle. So both these steps we are going to do together. Let's do it and show you the complete system. So now we are done. We have three pots, three hydroponic pots. We have filled in the water in this. You can see there is water in this. And we have filled the water only to the level that there were holes in it. And then we have, in the bottom, we have filled the cocoa peat, because cocoa peat serves as a very good hydroponic medium. And on the top of it, where it was top of it, in the sense where the these pots were top of the bottle, that was the part which was in air, I put very small amount of compost, the potting mix, very good amount, quality of potting mix. So this is, you can say, 2/3 of cocoa peat and 1/3 of compost. And next we are going to do is, we are going to place some seeds in these, and also we are going to paint this bottle at the bottom and also the pots. The reason for painting is just to avoid any kind of fungus on the base, since it will be placed in sun, in a shady place, but still some light could come in. And so we don't want those green color substances in a very good hydroponic system. And also I'm going to clean this up. Some amount of cocoa peat has fallen in between. I'll take a brush and clean this up. So that is not an issue. Rest of the system is done. And we'll place a seed today. Probably a seed which grows the fastest in this season. I'll figure out which one is this. But certainly I'm going to show you how are the results. So today is 21st of August, and we'll see the results in 7 to 10 days. So the painting is done. I had my colors with me, and my brush with me, and my colorful petri dish. I don't know why I want to show you this, but this was looking nice. So all this is done. You can color it as per your wish. I use the acrylic paints. You can use the spray paints as well. And next is to sow in the seeds. So I have these calendula seeds with me. This is how the seeds look like. I'm going to pick the best thicker ones and bigger ones and place two seeds each in each of these three pots. And my work is done. So we'll start with making a small hole here. And here, we Next, we are going to place two seeds in each of these small holes we just made. And now we are going to cover it up with small amount of the same mixture which is at the top. I mean, just cover it up with a hole like this. So this is what exactly I was doing. Similarly, we'll do repeat the same process in all the three pots and our work is done. Now make it dry, and these colors also serve as the purpose for the marking, because we need to change water after every 5 to 6 days, and when we do so we have to remove these small pots, get the water outside the bottle, place new water and then keep it back. So when we are keeping it back, the color has been done only at the upper surface and not at the bottom, so all the things which are colored should come up. And also, when we are going to put fertilizer in this, so although we had placed some compost at the top of this and only cocoa peat is at the bottom, so still the plant can get its nutrient, but it is also important to fertilize it from time to time. I won't fertilize it when the roots are very short. I will fertilize it when the plant is 3 to 4 inch tall. So I guess I have provided it all the information now. Right now, outside weather is sunny, so I'm not going to place it outside. Let this dry inside, and then once it is evening, it is cold outside, I'm going to place it there, and at a shady place where direct sunlight does not come. I'll show you the results after 7 to 10 days when these plants start to grow up as saplings. Today is 31st of August, and as promised, I have the setup with me. So you can see two sprouts in this first one. The germination started with two seeds, one in the second, and we have one small in here. So this one took time. Anyways, that depends on the seeds as well. But our germination has started and our hydroponic system is working well. Now all you need to do is that once their root starts to grow and they are really thick ones, that they go inside the water, then you need to provide your liquid fertilizer in this water. So all you need to do is just remove these and then provide the water from the spaces. And in between, what you have to do is you have to just tilt it like this from both the ends, like this, so that there is some air bubbles and also there is water circulation inside. That's all you have to do for your hydroponic system. Rest, the plant and the water will take care. And thank you. A giant marigold flower, and here we have some small ones. This is still to completely bloom. This is half done, but here we have a bigger one, but not as big as this one. So you can compare the two in the picture. And why is it so? Both of these have been grown from cuttings. Both of these have been grown from the cutting from same parent. Then why is it so? Why is the difference? The difference is hydroponic, which I always keep on telling you. This pot is growing. This plant is growing normal in a normal potting mix which we prepare. But this one is growing hydroponically. So if you see, there are two pots, one at the bottom and one at the top. One is having all the good nutrients and the other is having water. And if you see the roots, so bulk, heavy, white, thick roots, and hence you can see the result. I hope you have got the importance of hydroponic system and you would like to create one at your own home. Let me know if you have any queries. Thanks for your time. Do like, comment, share and subscribe if you have not done it so far. Thank you so much.